All right, here we go. We're back on the air. All right. So we're looking at Afroasiatic Perspectives, the 28th edition, entitled Which America?
Yes. Right. Which, sorry about that. Afroasiatic Perspectives 28, yes. Which America? So if y'all don't mind, I'm going to read it aloud.
All right. Okay, let's read it, yeah.
Here we go. So, quote, every black American is bilingual, all of them. We speak street vernacular and we speak job interview, by Dave Chappelle. Michael-san, do you know who Dave Chappelle is?
Dave Chappelle is TV personality.
So.
Good, yep.
Right, so he's a comedian. All right, and he says every black American is bilingual, so we speak two languages. All right, one is street vernacular, the other is job interview. That's the name of the language.
Job interview っていうのは普通に何かの方言みたいなのを表す意味？ジョブインタビューは？
標準語。
まあジョブインタビューの時に使う、まあ正しい英語っていうこと。ああ、わかりました。
Okay. Is there a difference between black America and white America? For those of us who have resided in the USA, the answer is simple. Some of my earliest childhood memories of the States involve my introduction into American culture, which by and large consisted of being forced to choose a side. Since my father was a strong black man, and both my sister and I, like him, were copper-colored, for us the decision was not much of a puzzle. Nevertheless, I can remember seeing other Asian black children, many of whom could have passed for my siblings, who preferred to associate almost exclusively with white kids. Although my list of friends transcended ethnic bounds, once I hit the teenage years, I rarely hung out with anyone who wasn't down by law, which was our lingo for being from around the way or from the hood.
Okay, so pause. Down by law, from the hood.
Yeah.
Around the way.
Yeah. And actually, I really kind of want to backtrack to that. You're saying that Asian people that you met that could have passed off as black as well chose to be white.
Yeah. Well, I'm talking about, biracial Asian black kids that I met.
Biracial Asian black kids. So they could have been, choosing to be white and choosing to be black.
Well, I'm saying that as kids, especially being so-called mixed, we were forced. It was clear. It was like, well, what you gonna do? You gonna be white or you gonna be black? Because there's no black Asian genre. There's no choice. It's A or B.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So in most cases, I can't even say most cases. In my case, we never really thought about it.
Mm.
But I think for other kids, even though they were darker than me or they looked like me. I saw them with white kids, and I never really understood it. And some of those kids never understood me.
Mm.
And we grew up like that.
Right.
Yeah.
Right, all right. And so then once you hit teenage years, lingo is down by law. So when you're saying who, you rarely hung out with anyone who wasn't down by law or who wasn't from around the way or from the hood, what does that mean?
In colloquial terms, it means I didn't hang out anybody that was black or wasn't Latino.
Yeah.
And they weren't the kids that were in our neighborhood. It was very, very segregated. And like hip hop, even for black people, if you weren't, you could be cool. I mean, you could be black, but if you weren't down with the hip hop set and you didn't have a clique, if you went, you couldn't roll up to the party. You would just get beat up. You wouldn't even make it in the party.
Mm-hmm.
Those kids weren't even interested in coming because hip hop was still illegal back then. Meaning we get arrested, anything that we did contributing to hip hop, they thought we were fighting each other.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, so we didn't see anybody but us events.
Right.
You know?
白人と黒人のグループがあったとすれば、例えばアジア人と黒人のミックスであって、ある場合ってどちらか選ばないといけないというような状況やったってことですよね。で自然と黒人のグループの方を選んでたっていうことですか。で他のそのミックスの人たちは、まあ、白人の方とつるむことが多かったっていうことですね。
Yes.
はい、わかりました。
Maybe,
ありがとうございます。
Very good. Maybe more than half. I would say of the Asian black kids、
はい、
for some reason、didn't consider themselves black. I don't want to say like almost everyone, but I think it was more, in my memory,、
はい、
my experience is more than half.、
はい、
and even when I, in Japan now,、
はい、
whenever I, when I meet Asian black kids, most、
はい、
of them, they're white kids. They're basically, they have white tendencies. They grew up in a white situation.And they many times date white people.
Oh, なるほど。
That I meet in Japan. I'm not saying everybody. I'm not trying to, you know, rub anybody the wrong way. In my experience.
ありがとうございます。
All right. Anyway, yeah, I was checking out some old movie called Down by Law. I was wondering where Down by Law could have originated from. But anyway.
Well, it really is like even now people say, "Yo, you, is he down?
Is he down? Yeah, I'm down for whatever." But、
yeah.
being down is just norideku, I don't know, sansei suru. You know what I'm saying? Like I don't know, like who wants a pizza? Like I'm down. It's like, "Ore mo pizza tabetai." You know what I'm saying? So,
よくヒップホップの歌とかで聞くのが、ああいうジャンウィスフィーっていうようなこと言ってることがあって、特になんか男の人がなんか女の人にああいうジャンウィスフィーって聞いてることがある。でどういう意味かなと思ってたけど、それって
一緒に乗るかみたいな。
あ、まあまだ一緒にまあ いるかっていう感じ、まあっていうか
同じ気持ちに乗ってる。
ああ、なるほど。あ、わかりました。
All right.
Back to it.
All right, mind you, from here, this was not due to any feelings of hatred or
okay,
animosity.
So this、yeah. means not hanging around with only basically black and Latino kids means it was not due to any feelings of hatred or animosity.
Right.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Okay, right on. Mind you, this was not due to any feelings of hatred or animosity, but rather it was because back in the 1980s, the culture of hip hop was really taking off. And at this point, it was a black and Latino members only club. In Philly and Jersey, the black white divide manifested itself in virtually everything that was interesting to youngsters. Musically speaking, funk, disco, and R&B were the genres considered as black music prior to rap being played on the radio.Disco sucks is what the white kids wearing the black and white Led Zeppelin and Pink Floyd t-shirts used to scream at us. Which confused me because all white groups like the Bee Gees or black and white mixed groups like KC and the Sunshine Band have been very popular. This was the first time I noticed the dual nature of American society. After all, it's everywhere from Democrats versus Republicans, right wing versus left wing, liberal versus conservative, etc.Of course, I didn't become conscious of all this until later in my life. As a kid, what caught my attention was how even amongst whites themselves, they were organized into opposing factions. The white boys who got stoned at keg parties to heavy metal, to heavy metal were cool kids.I'm sorry. Wait a minute. One more time.
Cool with the kids.
We're cool with the kids. The white boys who got stoned at cake parties to heavy metal were cool with the kids who zoned out to classic rock. But together they had formed an alliance against the whites who liked disco. I remember they used to speak very condescendingly, even labeling them as nigger lovers. All right. So in any case, in general, you can already see it. But there's always a divisiveness between different cultures around the world. And in America, and really around the world, the biggest divide is between white and black, you know? And then within that, there's subgroups, you know? You could even say that with other cultures that don't even have white and black people in the culture.
Yeah, per se, white, yeah.
You know, so it could be a whole Japanese culture. Who would you consider black in Japan? Who would you consider white in Japan? You know, so, you know,and of course, there's a lot of, it depends on how much money, you know, there's always the poverty and then the wealthy and all that. But we're not even really talking about the wealth gap. We're talking about everybody with the same amount of wealth and still pick sides. You know, America is very dualistic in that.
Yep.
All right, keep on going.
Yep. I think that's good unless she has a question. If she understands everything then I think it's cool, yeah.
You understand it?
Hobo.
Hobo.
So.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Getting stoned at keg parties means getting high. Okay. You get high.
No, don't go through all that. Yeah,
all right, yeah. So realizing how deep, see, I can break it down as far as you want to go. Leave it on. Realizing how deep the black-white divide in America was really blew my mind. All right, so let me read that one more time. Realizing how deep the black and white divide in America was really blew my mind.
Aww.
Okay. From that point, I was careful to align myself in all activities according to the established rules. And this would become important once the TV series Roots came out, because white boys around my way started to get beat up on a regular basis. The movie Roots, you know. I don't even think young people know Roots now.
Yeah.
Oh, know what I'm saying? But anyway, you know Roots?
Roots は、あの、
ルーツはあのタクワンさんの本を読んだので、その中でルーツの、
そう出ました
、ね、はい、そう説明があったので、イメージだけはあるけれども実際のルーツを知ってるわけではないです。
実はあのマイクより年上の、あのもっと上の時代の日本人でもルーツって聞いたことあるらしい。ほぼの生徒さん70、60歳の生徒さんが、うん、みんなルーツしてる。50歳は知ってるかなみたい、で40歳はほぼ知らないみたい。 You're like, okay, so 40、30は知らない、70は絶対知ってる、60も知ってる。
But even young kids in the States, a lot of them probably wouldn't know.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Just suffice it to know, even if you don't know what we're talking about, it was a show that talked about, depicted slavery one of the first times on television, mm-hmm. showing, and it wasn't really all that correct. There was a lot of flaws in it, but it really showed black people being treated really, really badly. Mm-hmm. And the reaction to it, at least in my hood, was white dudes got beat up. The next day, Kata, from the next day, it was on.
Yeah.
And yeah, they had
even
to change
that up. Even my generation, Roots was still, I was a little too young even for Roots, but I had to watch it. But I would liken it, if anybody was in a high school around the 90s, there was a movie called American History X.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And when that came out, you didn't want to talk to no white people after watching it. I remember all black friends of mine, we would watch American History X and be like, man, white people, man. Like, you know what I'm saying?
We're not here to take shots at white folks. We are here to take shots at the system called white supremacy, however.
Yes.
To make that clear. Nothing against any group of people.
Right.
All right. You ready to move on?
Yeah, I just had to make it a little smaller. Had to make it a little smaller. All right. The racial schism was particularly noticeable in school, where the only certified black activities were sports, but only some of them. Starring on the basketball, football, or track team could earn you a whole lot of cool points, while at the same time, being a member of the baseball, soccer, or lacrosse team came with a white boy label stitched to the uniform. Even in regard to simple pastimes like playing cards, the contrast existed. In the hoods, blacks played tonk or spades, yeah. But whenever we happened to be on the other side of the tracks, we had to settle for go fish, gin rummy, or poker. Yeah, and poker is real big around, you know, white people love poker. And it's true, like black people love spades just because it's like the black card game to play. As a young adult, I'll never forget how surprised I was to see a group of Italians shooting craps. Because I had never seen whites, if we can call Italians white, yeah, shoot dice before. Whereas on the other hand, everyone knows brothers love playing CeeLo as much as whites enjoy a good game of Monopoly or Scrabble. Yeah, to this day, I still hate Scrabble. Hey, but Africans like playing Scrabble though.
You mean like Africans from the continent?
Yeah, Africans from the continent, yeah.
Yeah, we talking about Africans from the continent who come to Japan and really know English, though. I don't know.
That's true.
I don't know if we can say they play that on the continent. These cats are, a lot of these Africans are Africans who, although they're black, might be black at midnight, they've chosen the white side. They're not from around the way.
Right. It's all about choosing sides. Yeah.
Yes. So it's not about being the color of your skin necessarily. Mm. Necessarily. You know what I mean? Like I said, we talked about Coons and Uncle Tom's and all that stuff yesterday. They're on the white side.
Mm, mm, mm.
And then you got some down-ass white people with blonde hair. They're on the black side. They've chosen to be on the black side.
Right, right.
You know? So it's not, we can't just say it's not just something we can just identify through race. Mm-hmm. It's more about your perspective. Mm-hmm.
Exactly, exactly.
All right, so pretty, I think pretty much that's pretty, is that clear, that first part?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
All right. Quick question, you know, just to Mayako now. Do Japanese choose sides?
もし日本人がどちらかのサイドを取ってるとしたら、ほとんどの人は白人側だと思うんですけど、うん、私の個人的な意見になりますが、それも別に意識することなく勝手にそうなってる、全体的な日本の流れとしてなってる気がします。
If there are sides, what is what would be the black side in Japan? What person, let's say a Japanese person considers choosing the black side? Because again, white and black are not races when we're talking about it in terms of just Japanese people. But if a Japanese person picked white Japanese or picked black Japanese, what would be a black Japanese?
例えばやっぱりヒップホップがすごい好きな人とか、まあ、ダンスが好きな人は、まあ、どちらかというとブラックカルチャーに興味があって、まあ、理解しようとしてるっていうふうに見えるけれども、さっきのちょっと前で出てきたブラックラバーズっていう言葉が出てきましたよ。
ブラック
ラバーズって出てこなかったっけ、なんかニガラバーズ、ニガラバーズって出てきたじゃないですか。白人の中でも、まあ、ちょっとディスコミュージックタイプとは違う人たちがいてたじゃないですか。そういうのと、そう、黒人のサイドを取ってるのの間ぐらいの人たちのようなイメージ、私にとっては。
That's interesting.
What do you think about that?
I don't know. I think when it comes to Japan, I think the other article analyzing the Yamato Code kind of hits it, because I think in Japan, white would be the regular Japanese way, which I call Yamato, right? But when you have like anything that's outside of that, because in black culture, we're the outsider people. We're the outside people. The law doesn't really pertain, doesn't protect us in the same way it does the mainstream people. So basically, white kind of turns into the mainstream. So in Japan, there really isn't too much outside of it. There's not too much outside of it, because you really can't go against the grain. You understand? Like, you can't do that in Japan if you're Japanese. I'm not saying it can't be done. I'm just saying I don't see it being done that much.
And it's not happening because, for the most part, the Japanese society looks out for Japanese people.
Right. The law
so
benefits.
There is no, why go against the system when it's designed for you?
Yeah.
See, black people in the States, is nothing is designed for black people.
Oh, you know, なるほどね. Hi, hi, hi.
So.
Yeah. That's the point. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Nothing designed for black people to thrive
to benefit,
as black
for them to benefit
as black people.
Yeah. Yeah. As black people. That's important.
Yeah.
っていうふうに考えたら、それはまあ例えばチューズインサイドと思ったら、日本の社会の中でブラックサイドを選んでる人っていうのがそもそも 存在してないような気がするんですけど、全体的に日本人の外にはみ出してる人っていうのが極端に少ない。
そう。だから日本人いつも、いやでもイエローとかよく言われたことある、or what is it like、イエローモンキーとか言われたことあるから同じ気持ちが分かるよ、like、yeah, そういう意味じゃなくて、差別言葉のレベルじゃなくて、この世界は、この世界は日本の世界、日本の国、言語、スタイル、日本人通りにやったら、日本人のヤマトコードみたいな感じでやったら、進められるよ、進むことはできるやん、ね、でも黒人は、いや黒人的にやったら失敗する、決まってんねん、白人的に言ったら成功するで、みたいな感じ、
白人向けの社会システム
を流れてきてるからね、
白人的なやり方でないとそのシステムの中で
Alright. Okay, yeah.
Okay.
Let's keep on going.
Good. That's what we want to do, break it down, make
break
sure we
down.
Understand.
Nowadays,
up until now, we're talking about the past, how in my personal experience, mm-hmm. how I came to realize that there's this dichotomy, this mm-hmm. duality between black and white. I call it black and white. Mm-hmm. So now we're switching to, you can see the transition. So now we're going to see how does that translate to 2020, even though I wrote this a couple weeks ago in 2019.
Yeah.
All right.
Nowadays, segregation and other forms of unfair bias are frowned upon in the media. Any person or corporation accused of practicing racism or sexism can be fined or imprisoned, not to mention have their character assassinated in the media. With such harsh penalties in place, it is natural to believe that acts of racism would gradually diminish, or at minimum, they would have to be concealed. Unfortunately, this does not seem to be the case. From Black Lives Matter to the murder, not simply death of Botham John, yeah. Botham John, and even the Bill Cosby case, 2019 was saturated with clear black and white instances, pun intended, of the black-white divide. No longer do I allow myself to be lured into debates as to whether or not racism still exists. This was a popular distraction during the Obama administration. Yeah. Back in the 1960s, President Lyndon Johnson assigned the National Advisory Commission on Civil Disorders with the task of assessing the causes of civil unrest in Afro-American communities. The Kerner Commission report, which was a compilation of data on the specific economic and social inequities confronting blacks, was present to the president in 1968. Last year, Janelle Jones, John Schmidt, and Valerie Wilson of the Economy Policy Institute published 50 years after the Kerner Commission in order to assess the nation's progress during this time. What did we learn? From someone like me, who at one time believed the system of racism and white supremacy was gradually weakening, or at least that blacks were little by little gaining a foothold in the American dream, this quote jumped out at me. Here's the quote. With respect to home ownership, unemployment, and incarceration, America has failed to deliver any progress for African Americans over the last 5 decades. In these areas, their situation has either failed to improve relative to whites or has worsened.
That's the Kerner Commission findings. Don't scroll it. Don't scroll it down. Okay.
Oh shit! I scrolled it up too.
Yeah. Luckily. No. Good. Yeah. Good. Good. That's good. Don't scroll it down because you're gonna go into the next.
Okay. Okay, so one quick one. The Kerner Commission findings, or the Kerner Commission, because again, I haven't read this either. You know, I'm reading it just right off the top. But Lyndon Johnson, who was the president who dropped the bomb?
No, this was way after that. No, way after that. He's one of those guys that had American Vietnam.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, the 60s. Damn. Yeah. My bad. Yeah, I don't know. Boys, you know what I'm saying? Anyway. Last year, Janelle Jones Johnson, yeah. So, they had a commission that went out and did a study on social inequities.
So, you know, basically, let me just say, so in the 60s, that's when civil rights was going on. Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, everybody kind of knows that. Mm. So it was in the media that, you know, blacks, everybody knew that they were facing Jim Crow. And in 65 is when the Civil Rights Act came into effect. That's when the blacks and whites were able to eat at the same counter and the same water fountain, et cetera, et cetera.
Integration.
That happened in 65, yeah. Right? Okay, so everybody knew that there was a problem between black and white America. Mm. So the president put together a team of experts to assess all of the problems. It was, as we say, specific economic and social inequities.
Yeah.
So what's unequal socially and economically between blacks and whites? And then, so this think tank was put together. And then they actually in detail talked about all of the problems or challenges facing the black community or the non-white community, because this also includes Latinos, Asians,
right.
Everybody who's not white, mm-hmm. or who is not accepted in the white. And back in 65, I don't care how much of a sellout you were, you still weren't allowed in, right? Okay.
So then, because sellouts get allowed in. Sellouts, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So then that was in what, back in 68. So 50 years. that goes back to last year, right? 2018, right? Well, now it's 2020. Well, just beginning of 2020. So these people, these three people from the Economy Policy Institute, Janelle Jones, John Schmidt, Valerie Wilson, other experts, they wrote a paper called 50 Years After the Kerner Commission. So in 68, you had a list of all the problems in detail. And then last year, we took those, looked at those same problems and just seen how much progress was made between 68 and 2018. Mm. And then the quote, it's not the only thing that was, right. was there, but the biggest thing that jumped out at me was, not only is it not, has nothing improved, it's worse in many cases for non-white folks. I'm saying African-American, that was their quote, but yeah. we could talk about more than just so-called African-Americans.
Right, right, yeah. right. So nothing has changed, basically.
Well, or it's gotten some, the changes are worse. Anything that's changed has gotten worse.
One that's changed is what I just said there was sellouts are allowed in now.
Right. Well, so for individuals, yeah.
For certain sellouts. I mean, you really got to sell out. But there are very successful sellout Negroes that exist nowadays that didn't before.
It depends on what your idea of success is. You talking about
I'm talking about
employment,
monetarily,
yeah. social
like,
inequity,
no family, all that stuff. And who knows? They can still come at you, but they can still come at anybody.
Yeah.
So, you know, the average reason of anybody selling out is to get with the winning team.
And we're going to talk about that more. It's coming up in a minute.
Now some sellouts can get with the winning team. Back then, no sellouts were even getting with the
right.
winning team. There was just none of that.
Right.
And now it's like some sellouts are getting with it.
Right. You just sleep in the big house, maybe.
Yeah. You know yeah. Now we got a black president once or twice. You know,
yeah.
Who knows? All right. So I'm going to move down now.
All right.
So then.
So who's that? Michael, who's that?
Oh man, and she's putting up the sign.
Oprah.
Good.
Oprah. Very good.
Yeah,
talk show host, richest black woman in America.
She's up there. If she's not, she's definitely up there.
But, man, is she putting up the Illuminati sign?
Okay, so let's talk about that. So she has the you can call it the OK sign, right? The OK, right?
And she young too.
Yes, when she's younger. This is back in the day, probably in the 80s, 90s.
Wow, she's a bad bitch. Okay, a lot of people are like, I get with Oprah. I was like, hell no, but that's a good-looking Oprah.
Yeah, but then again, you know, Hollywood makeup, man, like I said, if you get under Hollywood makeup,
that's true.
You know what I'm saying? If you ugly on TV, TV, you ugly.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's the most attractive Oprah picture I've ever seen.
Yeah,
but damn.
But let's talk about the yeah. So, Michael said, do you understand though that this sign?
The
OK sign.
Yeah, but it's right. Three Ks too, right? Is that what it is? I forgot.
Because it's W, and then you can be a P, right?
P. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I thought it was like OK, like 3K, like KKK. Okay.
I think that's one of them too, though.
All right.
Yeah, But I think a lot of people, look how she has it. It looks like a W, right?
Yeah, because what black people do that?
Especially like this, because look, it's like, it's W, and then this is a P.
P, yeah, yeah.
P. White power.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, now hold up. We're not saying that that's what she's doing. Oh. I don't know Oprah. Oh. That's why if you look at the caption, I'm saying, is she doing the okay sign or is she doing the white power sign? I don't know. Right. I don't see a lot of people doing that like that. Why is she posing like that?
Right.
She's saying, is everything okay?
Yeah.
What is she saying here?
Yeah.
It's clearly she's made up for it. It's a photo shoot. This is not just she did this.
Yeah.
You know, this is not a selfie, right? An 80s selfie. This is, she clearly is at a studio. She's dressed up, as Sterling said, the woman looking good.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? She got her hair blown out, and she's trying to let America know that, hey, I'm down with what white zaddy. If you go down, you'll see white zaddy. Does she have a white zaddy complex?
Yeah.
Zaddy.
Or is she saying okay?
All right. White zaddy is getting with a white man. A white man who is usually more affluent than you or has more money than you. Trying to get out of your situation. Trying to get out. Which is Are there Asian zaddies, Japanese zaddies?
Okay, well, zaddy itself is a yeah, that is usually a younger woman who's trying to get with someone older. An older guy is usually projected, or oh, he's a good-looking older guy or something like that. But many, you know, if it's a younger woman, economics mm-hmm. are going to be involved. The older man's going to dish out some money.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, mm-hmm. So it's not so zaddy does not equal white person. You can have a zaddy of any race, but in this case, we just happen to be talking about white zaddies. Mm-hmm.